The wife bought an apartment and then filed for divorce. She heard the conversation between her mother-in-law and her son. Margarita was returning to her home in the city. The mood was very bad, and long ago the last dear person on earth had disappeared. Margarita lived all her life with her grandmother, with whom she grew up and did everything for her, and now her grandmother is gone and part of Margarita's soul is gone. Today she was in the village where she spent her childhood, has been preparing the house for sale for more than 5 years, and she lives in the city, rents an apartment and works. The girl had absolutely no time to take care of this house, which stands alone in the village, and decided to sell it. At least she will have some money that will be on hand for sure. The girl dreamed all her life to buy a good apartment in the city, but this required a lot of money, so every penny was counted from every salary she took, but Margarita saved a little in her small chest. She always dreamed of living in the city. She no longer remembers her parents and suddenly stayed lonely, perhaps only 3 years old. Her grandmother tried all her life to replace her parents. Even Margarita was ashamed to say that she misses her mother and father. It can be said that she found her to have some kind of spiritual connection. They understood each other completely. The grandmother passed away a year ago, and Margarita also remembers how they lived happily together, and she still blames herself for not taking her grandmother to town, and she could have been against and take her to there. There she will be able to take care of her, but what do all people are getting old. Margarita sighed greatly. Now she was in the yard of the house where she rented an apartment. The girl stopped her old car and took out a small bag from the trunk of the car, in which she collected some of the things that were stored in that house, entered the apartment, put the bags in the hallway, and went to change her clothes. Life became so boring and monotonous that the girl no longer knew what to do with herself. She did not have a personal life, because she simply did not have time. Margarita has been working for a construction company for several years, and she has a very good salary, but in the end there is very little money left to rent the apartment, food, and clothes. Of course, Margarita understood that she simply wouldn't find a better job. She didn't even care to spend 15 to 16 hours a day at work, especially when she did not have time to complete the reports on time. Margarita made herself hot tea, stood near the window, carefully watching how the children were having fun. Of course, she also wanted her children, but no one. Not everything was so bad in Margarita's life. She had men in her life, but they didn't stay for long. Margarita often thought that she was the only one responsible for all the problems. Although in reality there was no need to search for the sinners, she met the first man for about 6 months, and then when they decided to live together, it seemed as if everything had changed. The man started staying at work a lot and he did not hear his girlfriend on launching. Of course, such attitudes towards herself, Margarita did not allow this for a long time. She met the second man for about a year, and the girl was in no hurry to move in with him, because she realized that everything could change at any moment. However, everything changed even without living together. It turned out that he was a deceiver, a cheater, somehow finding him with another girl. She was very anxious at the time. This relationship taught Margarita not to open up to the first comer, and now every time she started to love someone, she looked for a trick in him and, as a rule, often found her. Margarita was always doing the same thing on the weekends. On the first day she just sat at home doing housework, and on the second day she went somewhere to relax with her friends, but today she decided to do everything differently. She spent half a day in the village, which means she wouldn't have time to do housework, so she called her friend and offered to go somewhere today, and her friend didn't mind. And Margarita generally had a variety of friends who were very different from her. Sveta changed her friend guys at wind speed, "Don't eat her bread, just let me go on a date." She also has another friend named Olga, who is a very shy and modest girl who does not see anything good in the relationship at all. We can say that Margarita is the golden mean between these two girls. She is not against relationships, but she believes that Sveta often changes men. On the evening of the same day, Margarita stood near one of the nightclubs waiting for her friends, and finally Olga got out of the car, which Sveta also got out of. "Hey girls, I'm really tired of waiting for you. As always, we are late because of Sveta. She is very beautiful and all the time she finds nothing to wear. Don't listen, I always know what to wear, just because there was no right outfit today. Okay girls, stop arguing, let's go rest." "She really liked it," Sveta smiled. "Yeah, I'm just tired. I'm tired of constantly sitting at home. I don't know what to do with myself. I think a couple of cocktails will save me, let's go." After 2 minutes, the girls sat near the bar, chatting with each other. Then Sveta went to dance, and Olga sat sadly and looked from far. "Olga, I don't understand why you wouldn't start dating someone." "But I don't need anyone, I'm fine alone." "But you cannot be the same person all the time." You even want to let me know, Sveta was enough for me while driving, I talked all the way, just about how I met a great guy, but what really is it? Everything will be as usual. They meet for several days, then leave her, and she will grieve. I know all this, we have already passed it. Olga, this is the case with Sveta. But you can find a friend, and you will find you're the love of your life. Even if I did. He is definitely not in this club. Okay. Maybe in the library, Margarita laughed. Then she also went to dance, she danced as if no one saw her, and only Olga remained behind the table. Olga was not called an excellent student in vain, she was always right and that never made her feel ashamed, she met all the girls at the university and then Olga was really an excellent student, at the university no one spoke to her much, and they considered her very boring and boring, but Margarita was able on understanding her and finding her a good friend, then Sveta realized it. Now the girls were very friendly and constantly went to clubs. Margarita was dancing in the middle of the hall and a young man approached her, "Girl, let me dance with you," he said, trying to scream to hear him because of the loud sound of the music. "Well, go ahead," Margarita said, "keep dancing." The guy also danced near the girl, constantly trying to hug her. "And therefore, we didn't agree to put your hands down," the girl said, and she returned to Olga. And the guy chased after her, "Sorry, I didn't mean to offend you, it's all right." The man left, but on the other side of the club, he kept looking at Margarita. When she noticed him, she screamed and said, "This is not normal." The girls returned home and all the way Sveta tried to prove to Margarita that she was no better than Olga. Olga just sat and was silent, she was so accustomed to this conclusion to her friend that she did not pay attention to it. "You are always alone, always dissatisfied and unhappy." "And why am I unhappy? And what do you really have for happiness?" "Happiness in reading books cannot be called happiness. A window isn't for everyone to be very beautiful or as you should be." "Margarita, oh, I'm tired of everyone, take me home. You girls come to me just to sit and drink and not listen to me." Margarita came home that evening, fell asleep very quickly, the morning came too late, I was moved by yesterday's party. Margarita walked over and looked at herself in the mirror when she was only 27. And it looked as if she was 50. "Maybe we shouldn't have been drinking that much." All day long Margarita spent at home, and finally she arranged the apartment, washed clothes, and prepared for herself a regular meal. Lately she was only eating light meals, the girl always remembered her grandmother's words that this was unhealthy food and she should eat soup at least sometimes, so she cooked borscht today. She actually cooks a good margarita, but to herself she does the sandwich. That's how the weekend ended. On Monday, Margarita went to work, she was also waiting for a bunch of different reports and bits of paper that she immediately set about, and Margarita had a friend, his name is Dima, he used to work in the same place, she liked to communicate with him, they went back to have lunch together and drank coffee, so today at lunch Dima went to Margarita's office, "Let's go to lunch together, well, if you wait for me 5 minutes. Well, he started to wait for Margarita to finish working, he looked at the girl, but as soon as she turned around, immediately turned his gaze the other way, she took her cell phone and put it in her purse, then turned off the computer and got up. "Let's go, Dima." They walked to lunch in a cafe across from the office. "Dima, today I heard the girls talking that they had seen a new employee come to us."
"No, I haven't seen anyone yet.
Our girls are crazy about him, Jacqueline said he was so handsome that it's impossible to take your eyes off him." Dima laughed infatuated.
"Now I also want to look at him," said Margarita.
"But I didn't notice him as a man of particular beauty."
"Well, because you're interested in looking at girls more than guys, well, right after lunch, they're back in the office," Margarita told Dima all the way how she spent her weekend. Dima was a good friend of hers, but it seemed to her very boring and uninteresting, and in general she thought that for Dima there was nothing more interesting than work. However, when she was now in her cafe with him, she realized that he even had some hobbies and could think of something else.
I always wanted to ask you, do you have a girlfriend?"
"Now no, we parted long ago, and why did you break up?"
"Somehow we didn't agree on character, okay." As soon as Margarita and Dima entered the office, the girl immediately noticed that this new employee was really very handsome. Margarita looked at him without hesitation.
"It seems to me that looking at someone who is not very nice to give feedback is not good," Dima said.
"Oh, nothing, that I was just staring at a little bit." The girl sat at her table and kept looking at this employee,
and then after he whispered with the other girls, she discovered that his name was Stanislav. In the evening, as always, Margarita did not have time to report. She sat with a contemplative face when everyone was getting up to home. She was looking at the screen and not understanding what to do. Oh, the costs should be calculated as soon as possible. A man's voice came from behind. Margarita turned around and saw Stanislav. He was not only handsome, but also a tall guy. I looked at him and smiled. Sorry, I just got tired. I don't understand what to do. Well, I'll help you. So, Stanislav brought a chair and sat next to Margarita, dictating numbers to her, and she quickly took them in the report. Well, that's it. I always do it faster. Thank you very much. I'll always be here and can help you. No need for that. Margarita gathered her things and just got up, and the guy put his things in the bag. Maybe as evidence of grateful, Margarita offered to drive him home and smiled. Oh, that would be fine. You know, I live very far from this workplace. Well, let's go. Margarita drove Stanislav to his house, and during that time they talked about work and why Stanislav came to the company. She also discovered that he had no girlfriend and that he lives with his mother. She told him she had a dream of buying an apartment and the fact that it was about to expire. You're a purposeful girl, Stanislav said. Maybe I'll buy myself an apartment and live happy. Won't you feel bored alone? I hope someday there will be a young man who is able to melt my heart. Margarita came home. It was very strange, but in her head there were only thoughts about this man, in addition to the fact that he is very handsome and he is also a smart young man, and she couldn't sleep until she remembered his smile. The next day he invited her to go to eat in the morning. Of course, Margarita immediately agreed, but as soon as lunch came, Dima came to her. I was going to have lunch, shall we go together? Dima, you forgive me, but I'm going with Stanislav today. It's just that this young man is not indifferent to me. Yes, I am not upset. All is well. And now with Stanislav, they went to the cafe where she used to have dinner with Dima. She saw how Dima was looking. They were a little uncomfortable. From the day Margarita and Stanislav their relationship became good and all the women in the office envied her with white envy. He took care of her very beautifully and presented flowers constantly, albeit small bouquets. She always knew that they would be placed in her place of work, and a rose, of course, Margarita quickly fell in love with him. Margarita described to her friend Stanislav as if he was not a person but the very thing in which there is a true God. The girlfriends were very happy for her, and they waited impatiently to get to know him as soon as possible. However, Margarita was in no hurry. She only met him for 6 months and then he offered her to live together. Then Margarita thought several times whether she would agree with that immediately, but she was also very surprised when the young man offered to move to his house. What do you think? Let's go today and meet mom and then we'll live together. Honestly, I don't know. I'm somewhat afraid of all of this. There is nothing to be afraid of my mother. She is a wonderful person who will definitely love her one day. Stanislav still persuades Margarita to visit him. All of Margarita's worries and fears disappeared as soon as she went to Stanislav's apartment and met them a very sweet and smiling woman who immediately explained to Margarita that she was completely satisfied with her. At first, the girl was still afraid of the inconvenience of Stanislav's mother, but after a few hours she realized that the woman loved her and now, a month later, she moved into Stanislav's apartment. Now she did not rent an apartment and lived with her beloved. Margarita looks like she was in a true fairy tale. Stanislav's mother did not allow her to do anything at home. However, Margarita was not used to this. She always stayed to help her with everything, and thought that she would be very happy. Today was a day off. I woke up, turned around, was so amazed that Stanislav was not there. The girl left the room to the kitchen where Stanislav's mother was making pancakes. Do you know where Stanislav went? He's got some work, don't worry, he's coming soon. Strangely enough, he didn't tell me anything. Tell me it's coming soon. Stanislav is coming soon, while you're done breakfast. Margarita washed her face and was calm at the table, and it turned out that the pancakes were so delicious and she did not even notice how she ate a large amount. Oh, I'll burst. Everything will be fine with tea, Ekaterina Viktorievna smiled. A little later Stanislav came. Were you somewhere? I was very worried. Margarita started speaking from the entrance. Calm down, you must listen to me. From these words, Margarita was noticeably tense and stared with her own eyes at Stanislava. Margarita, you and I don't meet as often as necessary, but more than that I just can't stand it. I love you, girl. He put his hand in his pocket and pulled out a ring. Margarita, would you be my wife? Wife? Yeah. It might be unexpected, but I really want it. Of course, after all, I love you very much. Margarita of course agreed to marry Stanislav, in which she saw her happy life. They did a modest wedding. The person did not have much money, and Stanislav strictly refrained from spending the apartment money, and such a conversation took place between them. Margarita never think about spending the apartment money. You need to buy an apartment, because this is your dream. Yes, now we will live here together. Some money left, we will put it together faster. For Margarita it was normal because she wasn't having a great wedding like some of her friends, but she was really happy with this man, and now she's his wife and the happiest girl in the world. Margarita also worked and saved money, but Stanislav also promised to help raise the money, but he did not keep his promise. In fact, Margarita didn't want it because it was her dream. Once Margarita was married, time hurriedly ran, and for half a year she was living with her husband. Curiously, Stanislav's attitude towards her has changed dramatically. They were working together and in the same house. Of course it was necessary at times to rest from each other, so Stanislav often started leaving for his friends. At first, Margarita was positive, but once he started returning from there late, she had many questions. As it turned out, Stanislav couldn't answer anything she asked for. He was always confused about what to say. Or maybe he was cheating on her. This situation really upset the girl and she decided to talk to her mother-in-law. Stanislav's mother of course leaned over to her son's side and said that Margarita exaggerated the matter a lot and made the fly an elephant, and said Stanislav would never fool you. The next morning she was going to the kitchen to make tea for herself and she found that the kitchen door was a little open, and there was her mother-in-law and her husband. She did not want to hear what they were talking about, but through the conversation she heard her name, so she stopped. "Mom, I don't want to live with her anymore. I love Christina, but how long will this circus last?" "Son, wait until she buys an apartment and then divorce her." "Mom, I don't need it, you invented it all, but I'm bored with it and I'm not going to marry her." "Son, don't shout. Margarita might hear us, I'm not shouting." Margarita was standing at the door with her mouth open, and now she heard what would definitely destroy her life. The girl turned around and ran to her room, fell into the bed and started crying. Through her room door, she heard the main door shut. Stanislav might have gone somewhere. The girl decided that she would collect her things now and leave this house. She did not want scandals, heard everything and did not need anything else. In the evening Margarita took her bags from under the bed that she took with her to here. She folded all her things carefully and left the apartment, put the ring marriage on a shelf near the bed. Stanislav was not at home, so there was no one to stop her, and she did not want to talk to her husband's mother. She understood that it was her selfish plan. She called her friend Sveta, but Sveta was busy as usual on a date with one of her men. Then she called Olga, but she did not answer at all. The girl did not understand where she was going, so she thought that renting an apartment was not possible so quickly. It turned out that even she had no place to sleep, and the night was approaching, and it was raining. She remembered her friend Dima. She thought he could help her. Margarita called him, and directly told him that she was going to divorce Stanislav, and soon she explained the whole situation and asked for help. "Stand in your place, I will come to you now," Dima answered her. The girl waited for Dima, who arrived very quickly, loaded her bags into the trunk of the car and took them to him. It turns out that Dima lives alone, and he has his own apartment. "H.A. You will live in this room and I will sleep in the hall." "Dima, this is very embarrassing for me, forgive me, but I have no one else to turn to. You are my friend, all of my girlfriends have gone somewhere, I was so forced, I feel ashamed and you warned me." "Yeah, it's okay, I really like the guests." Margarita calms down, "Everything's going to be fine, you'll see. In a year you will remember it with a smile on your face. Thank you very much for your hosting. Why is all this? We are friends too." The next day, Margarita met Stanislav. She told him everything she thinks about him and even said a few words about his mother. She was very upset, but unfortunately, a smile appeared on Stanislav's face. "I am glad it all ended this way. I don't know where my mother came from with this nonsense, and I shared it. To be honest, I have never loved you. I have loved one girl all my life. How ugly you are. You know you are not the best. I felt so disgusted at being next to you." Margarita did not want to hear the insults anymore. She said that she is asking for a divorce. Stanislav was very happy about that. She returned to Dima again. Today there was absolutely no strength to search for an apartment and the man did not send it anywhere. She didn't start looking for an apartment until 3 days later. Dima apparently didn't want her to run away from him. He told her, "Why do you need an apartment? You will live here, until you save some money to buy your apartment. Just imagine how much you can save." "Dima, I don't want to embarrass you with this. Dima laughed. But well, if it is just prepare food daily and that is enough. A year later, Dima and Margarita got married. As it turns out, Dima has been in love with Margarita for so long that he has loved her so much, only a blind girl cannot notice it, Margarita too. Turns out, Dima wasn't so boring as that seemed to Margarita all the time. She realized how wrong she was, now she's really happy. In fact, the fact that she was with Stanislav cannot be called happiness, and now they are waiting for a child. By the way, she actually bought an apartment, but she rented it out because she lives with her husband. He had a very mysterious face.